basically, if you want to speak, if you want to be a good speaker, your tongue movement needs to be proper. Okay. Technically, your tongue movement is tongue plays a very important role. In order to improve the role of your tongue, in order to make your tongue more flexible, so that you can improve your, so that you can work on your pronunciation, you need to practice certain tongue twisters. Tongue twisters are very helpful. Okay, tongue twisters are very helpful. If you practice it regularly, you will be able to improve your communication a lot. So I'm going to start with some simple tongue twisters. Then I'll give you not a bit complicated, but a lengthy one. I'll start with some short tongue twisters. Then in the second slide, I'll give you a lengthy one. So all of you are ready? Here comes the first one. You have to speak 5 times. Okay, continuously you have to speak it 5 times. It is like Eddie edited it. Okay, so like this, you have to speak 5 times. Six sticky skeletons. Good blood, bad blood. How much wood would a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood? How much wood would a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood? How much wood would a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood? How much wood would a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood? How much wood would a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood? So this is going to be like this. Competence should compete where competency counts most. Incompetence should compete where incompetency counts least. Okay, so you can say like this: competence should compete where competency counts most. Incompetence should compete where incompetency counts least. Competence should compete where competency counts most. Incompetence should compete where incompetency counts least. Competence should compete where competency counts most. Incompetence should compete where incompetence counts least. Come on, you need to speak like this. Then only you will be able to achieve fluency.